We're here at the HDT booth with Rob Hodges, and we're going to be talking about the Hunter Wolf that the Army is interested in taking a look at. So, Rob, can you give us a sense of where the requirement came for this and what the goals are for the next step in this program?
So certainly, the requirement is defined by TRADOC as to lighten a soldier's load. The intent is to help carry the immense amount of equipment that a squad needs and to be able to increase the range and the time that they're able to persist. So 60 miles in 72 hours is essentially what we're going for. And this is now currently in a competition with four vendors. HDT is one of the vendors in that competition, phase two. It will go through a down select based on a technical demonstration that's going to put vehicles in the hands of two IBCTs, one at Fort Drum, the 10th Mountain, and one at Fort Campbell in the 101st Airborne.
And for the initial competition, how have you configured the vehicle? What exactly are you expected to achieve? What kind of capabilities is the Army looking for?
So certainly. So HDT's developed the Hunter Wolf, which you see here, and we believe that we've taken a very purpose-built design that's going to balance all the various requirements. So you need mobility, you need traction. We have a couple of unique features. It's a serial hybrid, so we have an internal 20-kilowatt generator, which is going to provide you not just the 1-kilowatt requirement on the move and 3 kilowatts at the halt, but we could export much more power than that from our onboard generator. It's integrated into the system. Noise is very important. You're worried about detectability for a squad, so keeping it quiet. We can run in a silent mode for several kilometers, which is going to allow them to essentially advance on the enemy without being detected. And in addition to that, reliability and ruggedness is key. You can't have the things breaking down in the woods as they're trying to advance on the enemy. So we've taken a very purpose-built, specific to this mission, and we've also leveraged the 10 years that we've been working this type of effort to really refine it from not just what we had before, but also understanding how the Army's going to use it.
And so this is made for all sorts of terrain, right? For a city, for woods, for off-road, things like that?
That's right. Right. So you could be on improved roads, you could be on gravel, you could be off-road. And, you know, if you go to the woods at Fort Benning, that's a typical place to test these. You go to Aberdeen and test it like they do trucks and other vehicles. And it's also going to go through a JRTC rotation at Fort Polk.
And so we have to talk about the gun here. So this is, right now it's not an Army requirement, but you're working on adding weapons to it and offering that to the Army in the future, correct?
That's correct. And the way we refer to that is modular mission payloads. So the Army's focus today is to get the base vehicle fielded. Lighten the load, that's the first increment. As we start to talk about what are the other things that you can do with this type of vehicle, casualty evacuation is part of the requirement now, so that will be addressed as we go through it. But then you can look at things like dismounted engineer systems. It can be mine rollers, flails. You could look at systems like a front end loader, backhoe, things to dig emplacements and fill HESCO barriers. So those are all examples of modular mission payloads. The weapon system to improve lethality is obviously something that's important from the squad level and also in the Marine Corps. Obviously, this is an Army program at this point. HCT is agnostic to the modular mission payload. In other words, we look at it from a capability standpoint. We look at what can it do to increase the squad's lethality and effectiveness. And if that's a remote weapon station, that's fine, whether it's a Kongsberg Crows, whether it's an FN Herstal unit. Those are all valid and viable because the system will support that.
And what sort of modifications do you need to make to the system in order to add a weapon system? I imagine it takes more power, a little bit heavier.
Well, we took that into account when we designed the system. So we understood that that is the future. And so that's one of the reasons it drove us to the choice to have a larger generator. Vice some competitors might choose a smaller generator and a larger battery. So that balance ultimately is going to yield a system that's better for modular mission payloads down the road.
And have you tested with the weapon, I mean, with different weapon systems on it and fired it and maneuvered it?
Yes, sir. We've done both live fire and blank fire in various demonstrations over the years. And in the spring, there's going to be another evolution down at Fort Bragg where we'll do the same.
So you'll be firing weapons down at Fort Bragg in the spring?
Well, I'll say that's the intent, but there's a lot of details to work out between then.
Great. Thank you very much.
Yes, sir.